What's up, everybody? Pal 702 back today with another high-end single coil RDA review. The Skyfall. It is finally time for the Skyfall review. Now, for those of you that do not know, ESG, which is ESMOKEGURU, they are out of Greece and they make very beautiful, well-machined, badass vape gear. Skyfall is no exception to that. Now, I've had this thing since November, so I've put a lot of time on it. I actually bought it used, but the gentleman that sold it to me never used this. He bought this, he has two of them. He bought this for a mod that he was gonna get, but he didn't end up getting the mod. And then he sold it to me. He watches the channel. If you wanna comment down below, go ahead. I'm not gonna put your name out there, just cause. So what we're gonna do right about now is we're gonna go downtown. I'm gonna show you all around the Skyfall by ESG. Pop a build in it. I have some excellent music. It is a combination of Las Vegas and Greece, believe it or not. Pop back up, pros and cons. You know how we do it. All right, and today it is the Skyfall Single Coil RDA by ESG out of Greece. And for those of you that don't know, ESG stands for ESMOKEGURU. But from here on out, we're just gonna say ESG. So it comes in this beautiful beechwood box, handmade. It has like, this isn't glass, it's some type of clear plastic. And then these three things right here are magnets. There's nothing on the back of this box. Just a quick look. So to remove the lid of your box, check this out. It's just magnets. So it slides right off. I mean, the presentation on this, this is why this thing is costs a little bit more than other high-end stuff. These guys came with a presentation kind of like Hussar. You know, some of the high-end companies now, they're stepping up. They're not just giving us those little plastic shitty boxes. Very beautiful display though. Now it's sitting on an actual, I don't know, it's like a Delrin kind of 510. So it just kind of threads in and threads out of this box right now, so. All right, so once you get the Skyfall out of the box, you will immediately be aware of the beautiful 316L stainless steel used on it. Just a quick look around it. The airflow, the AFC, all that kind of stuff, we'll break all that down. But you can see I have the triple air inserts in. There are two other inserts, which I will show you. And up top, you have this Delrin 510. And it just pops out like so. And just a quick look at it right there. It does have dual O-rings on it. And it's kind of rounded at the top right there. But for me, this is a perfect size drip tip for this. I don't use any of my drip tips at all. But for me, this gets you closer to the flavor, and this is the only guy I've rocked on it since I've owned it. Up top, now, this is a two-piece top cap, and this clear piece right here, this is made out of a polycarbonate called PC1000. And basically, what it is it's in a very expensive, polished, food-grade polycarbonate. You know, the material used on this, guys, everything on here is top shelf. So to get a better look at this two-piece top cap, let's just pop this guy out right here. Now you can see that you do have AFC right here. This does spin inside of the barrel and you can block off any of those holes, but really the air inserts are gonna do most of your AFC. If you buy, you know, all three of them or two of them or something like that, I don't use this at all. I run all three open, but this just spins inside the barrel, has a little O-ring right here. and just very well done. The polish on this, I mean, it looks like glass, absolutely beautiful. And then the actual barrel itself now, 316L stainless steel, and there it is, right down the pipe. There is absolutely no flaws, no scratches, no anything at all on this top cap. It is perfect. If you see some thumbprints or a nick here, a nick there, then that's something that I did. But this guy just goes right on the top like so. And then in order to adjust your AFC, you just grab this and you turn it and it will close. You know, whatever it does on this side, it'll do on the other side. And then your 510 goes right back in. And the dimensions of this guy too, it's gonna be a 22 millimeter. And then the height of this, it's like 19 and a half millimeters. So this is a very, very slammed 22, just the way I like them. And I know it's the way you like them too. So what does the SKYFALL RDA by ESG have underneath the hood? That is what she has underneath the hood right there. Let's just take a moment and just bask in the glory of excellence. Just a quick look around the deck here now. You're gonna have, you know, post here, post here. This is your positive, this is your negative. You'll see this peak, it starts right here. Now this peak, it's called Catron Peak. Catron Peak Quadrant. And it's a food grade, high temp peak insulator. And I'm guessing that it's extremely expensive. But if you look, it just runs all the way around right here. So you will know which one is your positive and which one is your negative. If you just follow that and then looking right down on it, you can see it around your squonk pin right there. Now your squonk pin is raised. It's raised about 2 millimeters off the deck. So you're going to actually use capillary action on this. This will wick up. It'll leave, you know, a little bit of EJUICE every time you squonk in the bottom. So it will keep everything saturated. This is not an RDA that spits back. It's just the way that this thing wicks and the way that it utilizes, you know, juice wells and stuff like that with a raised squonk pin. There's very little to zero spit back in pretty much any way that I've built it. Now on your negative post, you're gonna have your serial number, which mine is 818. And then if, let me spin this, right there, there is a series of numbers down there. And that is basically just like some crazy ass long coded out number to guarantee that no one can fake these. No one can clone these. I mean, you can clone them, but no one can pass off a clone as a real because of that number right there. That number is the key. And when you buy them too off the list, they do say they incorporate like 3 digits of that number for something. I think it's to go over to their site to buy or something like that. But that's what that number is. And you have, you know, Allen head grub screws, very nice. You have cutouts. So you're gonna have cutouts on both sides like that. So your wire, I mean, depending on how you wanna do it, belly up, belly down, whatever, you can do counterclockwise, clockwise. I do clockwise on this. You can fit, I mean, I don't put super crazy huge builds in here, but you could throw aliens in here, no problem. Like today we're just gonna do a simple fuse Clapton, but very nice right there. There's not really a lip to catch anything, but it just, it builds very easy. Dual O-rings on this, and then this is where the magic happens. Just look at every single angle on this RDA and every single millimeter of it is smooth. Every single millimeter of this is rounded, beveled. It's just machined absolutely perfect. There's nothing sharp on here. There's nothing inconsistent. There's no brush marks. There's just everything on here. It's just, the deck itself is just minimalistic, perfectly done. Now, the airflow, this is where it is not minimalistic and extremely, the craftsmanship involved and the airflow on this is just, it's next level.
Guys out.
And that is what it looks like with zero inserts, which you could totally run like that if you had some insane build, like if you're an insane-o-maniac and you did some crazy shit. I mean, you could do that, but that has like the airflow of like the goon or something. I mean, it's pretty massive. Also, by the way, I forgot to mention, it's about a 4.5 to 5 millimeter juice well on this. But it's really bigger than that. I mean, it's pretty hard to leak on this thing. But so airflow, the discs now, they're out. All right, so these are one of three sets of airflow discs that you can get, or inserts, if you will. I have all three. It comes with one. This is the middle size right here. So this is the smallest triple, and that would be 1.6 millimeter. There's three holes, they're each 1.6 millimeter on here. And this right here, these will give you a draw, I'm gonna say Haku Vena, right around the Haku Vena. Maybe a touch more airflow than the Haku Vena. But you could see all stainless steel. There's no O-rings, there's nothing. These things go into place simply by the tolerances of the machining, which is fucking crazy. These things snap in, they stay in, they do not come out. All right, now these are the biggest set of air inserts you can get. These are three, and each one is 1.9 millimeters. The airflow on this, like, had I ordered this from ESG and just taken one, I would have picked the biggest ones. But these are actually, it's a little too airy for me. This is in the neighborhood of, I would say, the Hussar Legacy fully open, and this might actually have, this does have more air than the Hussar Legacy fully open. Now these little guys right here, these are the mouth to lung inserts, and it is just one pinhole that's 1 millimeter. And also one thing I'll point out too is the length. As the airflow gets bigger on these inserts, the length gets less. So, and really quick, there are extras that come with it. You have two different Allen keys, and one of them is going to be for the 510, one of them is going to be for the actual grub screws, and you have two extra grub screws in there, several different O-rings, and then you will have a studded solid 510 right there. Once again, everything stainless steel 316L. So we're gonna pop this off of here really quick and snap in those air inserts so you can hear the beautiful snap. In order to put in, you know, these airflow discs, it's just super easy, or inserts, discs and inserts, whatever. I keep saying disc, but they're really inserts. This is gonna blow your mind. No O-ring. So we're lined up and just like that. I mean, there is absolutely no O-ring, there's nothing. It's metal on metal, and it clicks in, it clips in, and it stays in. It's an absolutely perfect fit. I don't know like how long it takes you to get this good at tolerances and everything else. Cause they could have done this. I mean, you guys have seen, you know, there's different stuff like the gas mods and some other, you know, like mainstream stuff that uses different air inserts, or like the wicked or other stuff like that, you know, and they always used some type of, you know, Ultim, or, you know, some type of PEI or PMMA type material. To do this with stainless steel and for it to actually click into place and fit perfectly. Yeah, I'm guessing this thing was in production, or this thing was in development for quite a while. And then across the bottom, you will have Skyfall and then the ESG logo on the bottom. Very, very clean. Once again, that very expensive ass peak insulator. Starts with K, I'm not looking back. I think it's called like K-tron or something like that. It comes with the actual squonk pin in it. and everything is stainless steel. Beautiful threading. And the squonk pin is protruding. It's pretty close, but you know, whatever, it's protruding. So before we build this bad mamma jamma right here, I just wanna show you a couple of extras that are from ESG. This right here, this is the DLC cap, which stands for diamond like carbon. And this is a very badass cap. Up top, Ultim. O-ring works exactly like the stock cap I showed you, direct from ESG. And then also you can get beautifully polished Ultim top. This is just the top, you know, kind of AFC top cap piece. And then beauty ring right here. All right, that's it guys. That is the Skyfall by ESG, the E-Smoke Gurus.
Hit it.
And that was a little bit of Dimitri Vegas Opa. That's right. You got a Greek DJ with a 702 last name, Vegas. I mean, it just works. But more importantly, that was the Skyfall single coil RDA by ESG, E-Smoke Guru, sitting on top of the SVX Squonker by SVA Mods, 20S in, 0.33, 0.34, fuse collapsing. Let's take it for a rip. All right, so what are we gonna do right about now? We're gonna go pros and cons. We start off with the cons, we end on the pros, because around here, we always end on a positive note. Cons on the Skyfall by ESG. ESMOKEGURU single coil RDA. There will be none. I have no cons for this. None whatsoever. I don't give a shit what you say. There is nothing wrong with this RDA. Now, pros. Get a beverage, maybe some popcorn, kick back, because we're going to be here for a while. First pro on the Skyfall for me is the airflow. This is the best airflow. I mean the best airflow of any single coil RDA, any RDA period, any atomizer period that I've ever vaped in my entire life. It is the quietest, smoothest airflow. I don't know if you can make airflow better than this. I don't know. I mean, when you first start taking your rip, you don't even know if your fucking mod is actually on. That's how smooth it is. I mean, just listen to this thing. It doesn't even sound like I'm taking a hit, and the mic is right here. I mean, it's just the airflow on this. Next is gonna be the inserts. The machining it took to make those inserts with no O-ring or no like Ultim or no type of PMMA or whatever plastic material. It's just mind blowing. The way that those snap in, I don't know if I got a really good snap when I was doing it down low, but this thing that snaps in, I mean, the tolerances across this entire RDA, the cap, the inserts, the everything, perfect. The machining, perfect. There's nothing. I mean, this thing is absolutely perfect. Huge pro. I love how they did this PC1000. Clear top cap on here. It just looks badass. And with the DLC I showed you, I just ran the regular stainless steel because it matches up with this really well. But on other mods, I run the DLC. That cap is fucking badass. Really badass. Kind of expensive, but well worth it. Drip tip for me, perfect. Super slammed down. I mean, it's only from top to bottom, not including the drip tip. It's like 19 millimeters, so it's a very slammed. So next pro is going to be flavor. The flavor on this, it's in the conversation of the best ever. It is. Whatever your favorite RDA is, single coil, this will be at least as good. That's a bold statement. Like, the flavor on this is, I can't say it's the best flavor in the world. It's, the Hussar V1 to me still pinpoints flavor, like, stronger than any RDA. But it's right there. I mean, it's right there on my Mount Rushmore. My Mount Rushmore of the Haku, OG Haku, the Hussar V1, the Hellfire Cobra. No, that's a squonker. The Hellfire Maverick and the Jenna. That is my Mount Rushmore. The fucking Skyfall just grenaded my Mount Rushmore. I mean, it blew the face off of George Washington. Fucking gone. Like, this thing, boom, on there. I would probably be willing to give this top honors. Like, I don't know how airflow and flavor gets any better. I mean, it's just all around, this thing is a bad motherfucker. Now, building it, you basically just want to line up your coil. Just, you know, because it's side airflow, there's no angles on those inserts. So you just want it basically a little bit over halfway up. So you want that airflow. Your coil should just be, you know, just slightly, you know, if you put your middle of your coil on these holes, just bump it up like a millimeter. So it's just a little bit higher. And then that's your build. There's no spit back on here. For some of you, that's a pro. For some, that's a con. The way that it wicks and everything like that is very similar to the Hussar Legacy. It doesn't give spit back. The way, you know, your coil is sitting up off your deck pretty far. So it does rely on capillary action. I think that has a lot to do with spit back. When you have coils that are, you know, basically slammed on the bottom of your deck, you know, and everything's slammed down and you squonk and it kind of squonks over your coil, you know, that to me, those type of singles give off a little bit more spit back, which I do enjoy. Usually I like some type of spit back, but the flavor and the airflow on this thing are so fucking good that I don't even care. Like, there's no spit back and I still love this thing. All right, I'm done. I'm fucking done. this thing officially on Mount Rushmore. I'd probably give it George Washington's face on Mount Rushmore. So that means a change on the Mount Rushmore. The new list, in no order, the Skyfall, the OG Haku Cruiser, the Hussar V1, and the Hellfire Maverick. That's the new Mount Rushmore. So price, what will the Skyfall ESG single coil 22 millimeter RDA cost you? It costs this guy probably a lot more than it costs you. I bought this, like I said, secondhand, but it was brand new, never used. There's a lot of ways you can tell, especially by on the bottom of the RDA itself. And I bought all the extras. You know, all three airflow inserts, all the DLC cap, the polish Ultim beauty ring and top cap. So let's just say I spent over $4 on this. And I'm not ashamed to say that because I fucking love this thing. But if you buy this from ESG, they do, it's Facebook and their link is right here. This is ESMOKEGURU. Right here. If you buy from them, they do work on batches. You know, it's a list. And basically, if you win, then they give you a code. And they also have a website that they sell other stuff, you know, like other modder stuff too, which I'll leave a link to that right here. Right there. But if you win this thing, they give you like a code and then you go log on to their website and then you can buy it. And it's basically, you're going to spend, I mean, it's like a $200 RDA, but by the time you spend, you know, for shipping and handling and stuff like that, this thing's going to reach you at about $225 to $250, depending on where you live in the world. It sells for right around $200, but after that's the taxes, and I think they got the VAT and this and that and whatever. European Union just rips people off. Like, I feel bad for you guys over there because those motherfuckers, they just tax the shit out of you guys. What is a VAT tax? Can you guys tell me what the VAT tax is? I don't know. Another place that you can find the Skyfall RDA, if you're not into the list thing or anything like that, is Stratum. So I'll leave a link right here. I know that they got some in like 2 weeks ago, and within like 5 seconds they were gone. So if you're looking for one of these, you have to be ready. Like, you need to have your stack ready, and when you see it, you gotta buy that shit. And if you're gonna buy it like I bought it, you know, direct from somebody, chances are you're going to pay over RRP, because this thing is one of those RDAs that I don't know why you would sell it. I don't know why you would flip it, but, well, I do know why you would flip it, because you could flip it for $300, $400, and there'll be some motherfucker out there that'll pay for it, because they know how good this thing is. I would like to send a massive shout out to the gentleman that is watching this video that I purchased this from. He said it was brand new. It was brand new. I looked at it. Thank you so much. And like all the stuff that you picked up and sold to me, it would be like parting with like your, I don't know, maybe not your firstborn child, but like your least favorite child, but still your child, right? So thank you to you. You can remain anonymous if you wish. Thank you guys for tuning in, and I do not know what is going on out in your world today, but I know it's Friday, and Friday is payday, which is my favorite day. So around here, with my Skyfall on top of this SVX, it is definitely all love, and I'm not worthy. And I will catch you guys on Monday.